Suckers, Mac and Mike, and making men of them. Tears and fears for my peers, they risen. You think that it is, if not it isn't. Race for the border, my daughter could beat her banging out. Chiefs rocking beats in the streets, and it's time for hanging out. Gather, or rather, for my circle around out loud. Just cause brothers or others could never ever rock a crowd. Is it because he's running off with the mouth? Or was he really clearly trying to play a n- out? Nope, shut him down, the king with the crown. Cause all you wanna be is Dickie Down.
In the life of every Nollywood actor and actress or any star, there comes a time when it appears like it's not working, when it appears like there's a slump in their careers. The role with that slump may inevitably lead to the end of their careers. They're at that point. It takes them to a point of greater success and glory. That point is called the breakpoint. And from the Script Factory Studios, Lekki, Lagos, Nigeria, my name is Chijoke Ebere, and this is my Nollywood story.
It's okay to parlay the forte better. Tell them. Tougher than leather, swing another Rodney King thing and I wreck, but just like the white one, I get no respect. Money stay awake, cause the other are fake, from Hollis to the Beacon, know your dumb ass is leaking. CL and Run DMC, so rush it, big time way before Hammer got to touch it. Remember the faces in all types of places.
Look, good day everybody, my name is T. Reginald Ebere, and you're welcome to the very first episode of My Nollywood Story. You're welcome to the platform. This is the very first episode of my Nollywood story, which is a place where Nollywood stars come and tell us their stories on their journey in Nollywood. And with me to introduce this program to you today for the first time is somebody that I consider special, somebody who is a close friend of mine, and that she has, in the past few years, become a mainstay in Nollywood. Her name is Cynthia Shalom.
Hello, Mr. Castle.
Hello.
It's nice to finally meet you.
I feel like I've not been fair to him. I know he loves me, but...
You have been cheating on him?
No!
Can I take you for lunch?
She's your cousin, or are you denying her?
Are you serious? Tamara is in your house alongside Andrea and the baby.
What do you want? Tamara? What are you doing here? Do you know that this is my home? And my wife is back in the country?
What is the meaning of that text message?
You don't know what to do!
Tamara. Cynthia, you're welcome to the program.
Thank you, drum roll.
Okay, let's see, we're going to have a lot of laughs here today because Cynthia is an absolutely funny human being. We're not going to ask questions concerning her comedy and how funny she can be. So, Cynthia, I'm going to ask you the first question and you'll be surprised what that question is. You are from Ebonyi State.
Yes, I am.
How come there are so few Nollywood stars?
Okay, so first of all, speaking of Ebonyi State, I would like to give a shout out to everybody from Ebonyi State. Hello, everybody! And I know my state is solidly behind me, so thank you so much for your support. Now to answer you, I don't think we have limited number of people from Ebonyi State in the industry. And then again, I think it would have to do with your interest and passion. But if you'd like me to give you a few names, we have me, Cynthia Shalom. And then we have, for actors, we have Angela Okorie, which is Ebonyi State.
Angela is Ebonyi State.
Grace Amah is Ebonyi State.
I knew that.
Okay. Yeah. We have Andy Chukwu, who's Ebonyi State.
Okay.
And we have Sinach, you know her, the gospel artist, yes. Sinach, she's Ebonyi State. We have Pato Rankin and Tekno. over. See these amazing people now.
Just seeing Paturankin and Snatch does it for me.
Thank you.
Grace has been a big friend for a long time, and she's on this program next week.
Oh, wow.
Yes. So, welcome from Ebonyi State to Nigeria.
Thank you so much.
To the rest of the world.
Thank you.
And you are here to help us tell us about your Nollywood story. So what exactly is your Nollywood story? I would like to start out by asking you, how did you come in and when did you come in?
Okay, this is indeed a story. So let's see, how did I start Nollywood? As far back as, say, 2013, Nollywood story. Okay, so through a friend, I had gone to do a movie in Calabar. And then that time, Afrif held their festival in Calabar. So one of the days we had said, oh, okay, well, don't we shoot early enough. Let's go to Tinapa and see what's going on. So we went to Tinapa. And here was Mr. Shegwa Rinze. I had met him probably 2 years before the time, somewhere in Port Harcourt. We really didn't talk. I just took his number, but we never spoke. I never called him. So he didn't even know me. I'd seen him. He saw me, spotted me. He was looking at me, and I was wondering, hey, I couldn't tell if he recognized me or not, but in my heart, I was saying,
they think we should stop recognizing young women.
It was actually good he did, though. You know, I wouldn't be here today. So I went up to him and to say hello to him, thinking he recognized me, you know, but then it turned out he didn't know me, actually. So he asked what I was doing there. It was good to have met me. So he's like, what do you do? I'm like, I'm still a student. I was still in school at the time. So when are you leaving school? I said next year, which was 2014. And then he said, oh, he owns an agency. He sources for talents, you know, to manage. And then if I would like, after school, come into Lagos, try 6 months and see. Then I can make a decision if this is a path I would like to follow or not. So after school in 2014, I came into Lagos. And the first show I got on was Mona Lisa Chinda's talk show. She had a You and I talk show then. And then before the talk show, there's always a 5 minutes, 5 minutes drama before the show starts. So that was the first thing I did when I came to Lagos. I wouldn't say it was easy. It wasn't. I have paid my dues. That's the language, right? No. So yes, I have. That's how I got into
Nollywood. I can only make an observation. Mona Lisa Chinda, I met her when she was a young woman.
Wow.
When she was in school in Port Harcourt. And every time I see Mona Lisa, it's like, she's still that young little girl I met in school.
I know, very glamorous.
Yeah.
Always.
Yeah. But so since she's connected to you, that makes you a special person.
Thank you.
That makes you a special person. I've also always known that she was special. When was the first time I met you? Can you remember?
When was the first time you met me? 2014.
And you were doing Next Movie Star.
That was 2015. Then.
2015, yes. That was the first time I met this young woman here.
Mm.
And she stole my heart.
But we never worked. How sad.
Never worked. But who said it wouldn't work?
Oh, well, I'm here now, so it's a good foundation.
Okay. So you've been in Nollywood since 2014?
No, technically.
Yeah. And you've
maybe
done
professionally
this.
Professionally, 2015.
You've done this and you bought the T-shirt. And you have become one of the most recognizable names.
Yes, and hopefully.
So what exactly what you call the high point of your career?
I don't think I'm there yet. I mean, I think high point or fulfillment is different for different people. Even if I set a standard for myself and I get there, you still want to do more. So at that point, you're actually not where you are yet. But so far, I know I have been able to carve a niche for myself. And like you say, the name is, you know, when you hear it. So
I mean, what can you do when you hear Cynthia Shalom? You just have to recognize.
So we're still working. The whole idea is to work and push until you no longer have to introduce yourself. So until then, we're still working.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That's beautiful. So what is the movie that you have done that is most challenging for you? Which movie is that?
I think it would be producing my own film.
Okay.
It's called Chain. I did a production in 2018. And the reason why it was challenging for me is because I had to produce and act at the same time. So you know the stress going through pre-production, production and post, and then still trying to interpret this character, trying to make it believable. And you know, the challenge of trying to sell it to platforms as well. So you know you have to deliver all around to be able to get this content out there for people to appreciate your work. Mm-hmm. So putting all this together was really challenging, but I'm really glad it came out well.
Cynthia, I would like to know a little bit about family.
Okay.
How many you have? What was your position in the family? What was school days like?
Okay. I'm from a family of five. I have three brothers and my younger sister, who's the last one.
How old is your sister? The last one?
My younger sister?
Yeah.
Let's say she's like 23.
Okay, she's like 23. That means that you'll be like 25.
Oh, well.
I didn't ask her.
I look 25. But I'm actually older than two people before her, so
okay.
You can guess. Anyway, school. School days was fun. Because I had my primary and secondary education in Port Harcourt. I also went to the University of Port Harcourt. I studied management. So.
Okay, I was wondering, I knew you went to the University of Port Harcourt, but I was wondering why I never saw you in the University of Port Harcourt, because I was like a resident visitor in the University of Port Harcourt.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say you actually graduated from Port Harcourt.
No.
I guess I wasn't born at the time. I was there to remind you.
I know. I am not that old.
Okay,
I refuse to be that old.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The University of Osaka was a fun place. Yeah.
It is.
I did a couple of shows and programs there.
Sure.
I still go back there. I'm going back there next week, actually.
Nice.
So, in the court, people.
Unique, in the pool.
Chuba people.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is one of you, and there's something amazing, really. University of Port Harcourt has more people in the industry than any other school in Nigeria.
I agree.
You can just count them.
True, a lot. I think their theater art departments actually took that craft seriously.
Yeah, they still do, and I'm still looking for more people in University of Port Harcourt.
There are a lot of them. You guys, show yourself. Well, this is an opportunity.
In case somebody's sitting down somewhere there. If you're from University of Port Harcourt, Regina Ebere is looking for you. You have spoken about your journey in Nollywood. Who inspires you most in Nollywood? Who do you have mad love for?
Who inspires me? Well, first of all, God. Secondly, humanly.
Now, you say God.
God gives inspiration.
God is not an actor in Hollywood.
Oh, he gives inspirations. And then if he didn't give me this talent, I wouldn't be here, first of all. So, him. Secondly, me. I inspire myself. Because going through the phases I've been through, you know, we have those days where you actually sit, check, you know, to ask yourself, am I doing right? Is this where I'm supposed to be? The frustrations come, the depressions come. But then, that's why I say I inspire myself. So, when you have the inkling in you to know that you are in the right place, it's okay to cry. You pick up.
So, you think you're in the right place?
Yes, I know I'm in the right place. I know I'm in the right place. So, I inspire myself.
That's actually beautiful because most people in Nollywood don't think they're in the right place. They actually think that they're in the wrong place. And they just happen to be doing this because there's something else for them to do.
Yeah, but that's true. Sometimes people do things to survive the moment, even though they know they are not in the right place. It's worse if you don't even know if you're in the right place or the wrong place.
Now if anybody asks me that question, I'll ask them, why is he asking an obvious question?
Exactly.
Because I'm in the right place.
Yes.
This is the only place I could have been.
Exactly.
When I
was leaving secondary school and going to university, and they started asking, what would you want to read? I told him the theater arts. I bought the jam form and theater arts. And my dad wanted me to go to University of UNN, University of Nigeria, Soka, and he wanted me to read another course entirely. How do you know?
Oh, they always wanted to be a doctor or a lawyer, something professional.
I could not have been any of those.
Yeah.
I just had to be a theater artist.
Yeah.
And from being a theater artist, I moved into film. Since I moved into film, I have not said that.
Mm-hmm.
I think she's one of those as well. Which is why I called on to her that much. Then, Cynthia, this is a personal question now. Why haven't we worked together?
Why haven't we worked together? Coming from you?
Yes.
You're the producer, you're the director, you're the EP, you're the everything. How do I get to answer that?
No, I'm not.
I'm just a bare employee, so to speak. I mean, you hire and fire me when you like. So it's just a phone call away and you haven't called me. Okay, guys, please help me ask him why I haven't worked with him. You heard him say I have known him for how long now? 5 years?
No,
since 2015.
Since 2015.
In fact, I will disgrace you now. So I want to believe that because you met me in 2015 and this was just a young, promising girl. She was not known at the time. She was not a face. You didn't think you could cast her for a job.
No way. So because she was a beautiful face.
A beautiful face.
Mm-hmm.
But not a face to work
with. And she had talent.
Now, that's even what I'm going to complain about. I've been angry about this thing. Can I say it?
So
producers and to directors, you guys should let the underdog shine. The industry is big enough to accommodate everybody.
But Cynthia, you cannot say that to me.
Oh, well, I'm just addressing them all.
Okay.
Producers and directors. Honestly, it's tiring to watch 5 or 10 films and you're seeing the same set of people in these movies. And there are people who have amazing talents just looking for platforms to showcase their talents, but they don't have it.
Are you guys listening?
Yes, it's not just to the producers, to content buyers as well. They all have a list of faces they want to see before they pick your films. It's wrong. These people you use, they are people who give them these platforms, they are people who picked them to say, okay, I want to see you grow, let me help you build your career. And they got them to a certain point, but you decide to choose them from the level they are at and then just keep working with them. It's not fair on the upcomers, it's not fair for new actors.
I agree absolutely. And I don't think I can be accused of that because I have worked.
Well, you asked the question, I'm sorry. So maybe you have to defend yourself right now.
Consistently with a lot of young people, a lot of people who are coming into the industry for the first time.
Yeah.
And Cynthia is, this is a secret, she's somebody I have always wanted to work with. And somehow or other, she's never around when I'm casting it.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. but that's good. I would like to ask, what is that one thing that touches your life that you want to talk about that you have never spoken about before?
One thing that touches my
life?
Yeah,
it might be a course, it might be whatever.
Touches my life?
Yeah, it touches you. Something that you are touchy about. Like if I talk about women's liberation or child abuse, your hackles rights. What is that now?
Well, I think first of all, see, I'm a very emotional person, so I don't think it's just one thing. Because I'm very emotional and I actually pay attention to feelings. A whole lot of, it might be minute, it might be very careless or minor to a lot of people, but very important to me. And talking about what touches me, especially in the recent times, is actually raping girls, or, I mean, anybody can be a victim, but raping kids, adolescents, adults, whatever it is, girls, boys, whoever does it. It's barbaric. It's an emotional thing to always talk about, and it's really shameful if you have to talk about these things.
It's not barbaric. I think it's demonic.
Exactly.
But I got a surprise from the fact that most female artists did not speak up, especially about the incident. about the Benicia and the young woman who was killed in church.
Yeah. No, a lot of us did now. We did.
Not too many people. Not as much as I expected.
Well, sadly enough, I cannot defend them. All I always say is, first of all, it's their platforms, it's their pages, it's their data, it's their phones. They have a right to post what they want to post or not. Now, for me, I could read a very sad story and I probably may not know how to show the public emotions, but I may just be in my private space and I'm mourning. But because people want to see that you feel this way, so you get to post, and it may not be in your heart too. It still doesn't mean that you don't feel it. But sometimes you don't just want to show these people that this is how I feel, but because they want to see you express it, that's the language you understand, you're forced to post. So I guess it's not because they don't feel it, but maybe they didn't pass it through the right channel and all of that, that's why you didn't see. But a lot of us did.
A lot of us are still doing.
Yes.
Some of these things are happening in society, shouldn't happen. In the least, they shouldn't happen.
Okay.
I live in Lekki. A lot of us love us. And you share neighborhoods with Lekki boys who do not have any things. And it has become like a part of everyday living to see these same people. They play football with you on Saturdays. They go to the same restaurants. I don't think it should be like that. I think society should be harder than people. But we are not here right now to reform society. So I'm going to ask her a few questions. We are in the present today. What will tomorrow be like? What is your tomorrow like? Are you going to work for some time and leave the industry and do something else? Are you going to always be in this industry? Are there other things that you want to do that you can be as passionate about as being in Andrews?
Sometimes life throws at you what you don't plan, and you have to make do with what you get sometimes. But for now, I'm still in the industry. I want to take on more trainings. I want to possibly get to study directing. And then I can't tell what the future holds. I mean, it's up to God. We only hope and pray for life in as much as we have our goals and plans. But for things I haven't done that I would like to do, okay, I'll break it down. Mm-hmm. Personal life,
yeah.
I have to get married. I have to have my own kids. For career-wise,
I hope you guys are listening.
Career-wise, I would like to do a life-changing project. I still haven't won my awards, so I want my AMVCAs, the Oscars,
you
Academy Awards.
You were in the You were best new actress.
Oh, I've gotten nominations. I had 2 nominations from Best of Nollywood Awards. I had a nomination from Maya Awards. But nomination is something. We want to win. You know, that's how we measure our work, you know, so our performance and all of that. So I still have my awards to win.
Guys,
yes, so seriously. And then business-wise, I have a lot of ideas ongoing. So I'll just have it to chill. Sip a glass, sip on your drink, and wait while it comes out.
Okay. People, this has been Cynthia Shalom. Mm-hmm. I don't want to let her go, but I will have to let her go.
Aww.
Because there's so much she's going to do. So, Cynthia, you're not going away yet. You're still here with us.
I know.
I would like to tell you that we, the fans, I'm a fan. We, the fans, will love you.
Thank you.
We want to see so much of you in the future. And I'm telling the producers too, when you want to cast your movies, look this way.
Thank you.
This young woman is one of the best in the industry, professionally, then personally. She's a good person.
Thank you.
And,
this is your star of the future. Better look at her, Cynthia Shalom.
Yeah. No, that was better than what I was with it. That was better than I would like to thank you very much for opening the platform for us. You are the first person on this platform.
Drum rolls!
So, for trusting us and trusting what we are trying to do, for being here and being able to make me talk
and present this program when I am not exactly the right person to present it because, you know, I'm challenged health-wise for now. I can't even talk properly. For making me to be able to talk up to this point, I'd like to say thank you very much.
Thank you.
And this is your Nollywood story.
Mm-hmm.
So, sure.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me on this show. Thank you to everybody, the producer, the director, the crew. Thank you. My Nollywood story. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, guys. So don't go away. All you have to do is stay here, watch My Nollywood story, invite your friends, get registered, get yourself registered on the platform. Keep watching because there are lots and loads of prizes to be won. There's a car to be won. I'm sure you want to go on a weekend getaway for couples. We have phones. We have several other prizes that will be bringing your way. As you stay here, don't touch that die. My Nollywood story.
Suckers, Mac and Mike and making men of them. Tears and fears for my peers, they risen. You think that it is, if not it isn't. Race for the border, my daughter could be to banging out. Cheeks rocking beats in the streets and it's time for hanging out. Gather or rather for my circle around out loud. Just cause brothers or others could never ever rock a crowd. Is it because he's running off with the mouth? Or was he really clearly trying to play a n- out, out? Nope, shut him down, the king with the crown. Cause all you wanna be is Dickie Down. A friend of mine asked me to say some MC rhyme, so I said this rhyme I'm about to say. The rhyme was Mecca and then it went this way. Recollect a Mecca mic check on a windmill skill. Mac the steps wearing Godfather hats. It's okay to parlay the forte better. Tell him tougher than leather. Swing a-